capital markets globally as well as in India looking in fine shape in spite of the volatility induced by US elections, which are expected to be held on first week of November. We find that markets are moving ahead and have started factoring in fiscal 22, FY 22 prospects of corporates and have started valuing them based on that. The central banks across the world, including in India, have come up with policies which are extremely liquidity positive, and the liquidity support is ensuring that there is no dearth of money chasing the good stocks. As far as Indian markets in the coming weeks are concerned, we believe that sectors which have shown strong resilience and the option to capture bigger slice of the pie during and post the COVID crisis, like technology, like pharma, are going to do well. They are going to remain bedrock for the capital markets in India and also globally. We believe both these sectors are in the midst of a revaluation, re-rating, and the same is expected to continue for some more time. Good quality frontline stocks in both these sectors should be acquired by the investors whenever there is an opportunity. Apart from the above, there are enough opportunities emerging in consumer staples, consumer durables, and also economy-related sectors in India. I will specifically mention sectors which will benefit from the infrastructure spend of the government in the coming days, and one should start looking at cement companies and other related infrastructure companies at the earliest. Power sector seems to be stabilizing, gas sector seems to be stabilizing, so the gas distribution companies post the new gas pricing policy can be looked at. Overall, I believe the market will continue to remain bullish with a very, very clear positive bias.